Hi, André. Thank you for joining me. I'm kind of excited to see what you guys have. And before we jump into the interview, could you give me a quick introduction of who you are and what do you do at Halborn?
Nice to meet you, Ben. So I'm André Martineau. I'm a product owner of Ziion. And I used to be an offensive security engineer for Halborn, and then we transitioned to making me product owner for Ziion, which is a VM that we developed at Halborn.
I keep hearing about Ziion. Everyone keeps mentioning it. What's the story behind it? What is it, you know, what does it do? How did it come about, and what made you guys want to create something like that?
So the story behind it is Ziion was originally created by Gabby Urrutia and Steve Walbrell for their Sense course initially. And it consisted of just a Ubuntu VM with some tools for solidity auditing. And so when I started working at Halborn, I used that VM and realized that it was a bit outdated. So I asked them, hey, can I work on this? And they said, sure. So I was doing my audits and working on that VM at the same time. And then at some point, it became evident that we needed to really put some more focus on the development of Ziion as a product.
With Ziion being, you know, very much focused right now on Web3, where do you see it going? Is it always going to be focused on that, or is it going to be extending to other things? What do you see it going in the future?
Right now, it's specialized for Web3 auditing. It will always be a tool that will do that, but we will basically adapt and implement other tools depending on the market changes, basically. For example, we're going to add IoT tools to audit IoT systems because they are also going into Web3. We have reverse engineering tools, for example, to decompile some of the WASP files, etc. So it's oriented Web3, but it contains tools that covers pretty much the whole spectrum of what we need to do at Halborn.
With Ziion being open source, anyone could go and install it and use it, right?
Yes, that's correct. So you can have a turnkey VM solutions. So people go to the website, they download the VM, and in a few minutes, they have it running. We will have also an Ansible version. So somebody, for example, installs its own Debian version, is able to run the Ansible playbook and install the different modules that they want for Ziion. That also allows people to see clearly what's being done to a raw Debian VM, basically.
I kind of look at Ziion being, you know, cybersecurity specific operating systems. You know, you have Kali Linux for a lot of the, pretty much the, what I would look at it as like a Swiss Army knife of hacking operating systems. You have Preyed OS that's very focused on vulnerability management and pen testing and that kind of things. And I feel like Ziion is, you know, the equivalent of doing that for crypto and Web3. But with all these tools, you see them being updated very regularly, and sometimes you see people create tools for them, and then, you know, they update and push it to these different operating systems. Is Ziion something like that? Do you guys allow the community to contribute to it? And if so, how do they do that?
Ziion is definitely something like that. We basically are, in a nutshell, if you have to explain it to somebody, like the Kali Linux for blockchain. We have internal tools that we are developing and that we will add, and people will be able also to contribute to the GitHub that we will have to submit tools, for example, or idea or suggestions or features. In the last release that we had last year, we implemented most of the features that were requested. They were already planned in the roadmap, thankfully. And the feedback was amazing and positive for that. So we will implement tools. People will be able to modify things or to fork things if they want to. We have already some repositories that will be made public when we will release the next version. And then we'll grow from there, basically.
With Ziion, what is the ultimate goal? Where do you, in 5 years, 10 years, I mean 15 years, where do you see it going? Like what would be the dream that you will hope to accomplish with Ziion?
So in 10 or 15 years, which is like a very far horizon, even in 5 years, because in crypto world, it's going like very fast. What we want is to have Ziion help secure the blockchain ecosystem as much as possible. Because in the end, it's people losing money. It's people losing their savings. When we work at securing smart contracts, we work at helping people keep their money, not being robbed, basically. So Ziion will help other offensive security engineers all around the world, not just at Halborn, but everywhere, to secure the applications in a more efficient way. With the different tools that we will create and the ones that we implement, have more ways of finding vulnerabilities. Because if we can find vulnerabilities before the bad guys do, as you know, in pen testing, we can actually patch things up and make it more secure. So that's the goal of Ziion, is really to secure the whole ecosystem, whether it is for finance or for enterprise or for other even cybersecurity companies, if we use blockchain at some point for that too, because that will be the future too, using blockchain technology into cybersecurity. Because right now we are basically securing blockchain through cybersecurity, but it can also work both ways. We can have systems in place to verify identity, for example, because the blockchain is immutable and you can literally check the data to see if you're impersonating somebody or not. You can have smart contracts running to help prevent events. So we have faster incident response time automatically. So there are ways to protect the blockchain, and also in the future, the blockchain protects us. In both cases, Ziion will help secure those smart contracts or those mechanisms.
Nice, very cool. And how often do you think you guys are going to release updates to Ziion?
The goal would be quarterly. We aim for quarterly releases of Ziion. So right now we're going to release the 23.1, 23 being the year 2023, and 0.1 the first quarter. And we will try to follow that release schedule from now on.
Very cool. Well, for everyone watching this, I'm excited to see what you guys put out for Ziion, and I can't wait to see what it turns into in the next couple of years.
Yeah, me too. Actually, it's very exciting. And if people want to contribute or have more info, they can go to Ziion.org.